Welcome back. In this video, we're going to be taking a look at bank reconciliations, which is the process of comparing what's in your NetSuite instance to what actually exists in your bank account and handling any discrepancies between the two, generally on the side of your NetSuite instance. So let's get into this. So I'm here in the home dashboard, currently in the controller role, and let's actually go to the tool that we're going to use to do the bank reconciliation. So I'm going to come up to financial, going to go down to banking, and we're going to come down to match bank data. So if I click on that, and it brings us to this match bank data tool. So this is where we're going to do our bank reconciliation. And really, just to orient you first to what we're looking at, we can see we select an account up here on the top. And then on the left side, this is going to be where the bank information is. So any kind of transactions that are hitting your bank is going to be on the left. And on the right is transactions that are stored in our NetSuite instance. It's going to be very similar, you'll see, to a CSV import where you're kind of comparing the two sides and you're going to be linking things together. So first off, let's just click and add. In this case, we just have one account available. So we'll click on that. And notice what happens. As soon as we do that, the right side here is suddenly populated with all these payments and bills that are related to this NetSuite instance all fill up there. Now, in this particular case, keep in mind, I am in a demo account. So this isn't hooked up to any real bank account. So notice on the left side, whereas in most instances, you're going to see this populate with all the bank's information for this particular account, we don't actually see anything here at the moment. Now, when you're approaching a bank reconciliation, there's really four ways you can go about doing it. And I'm actually going to start with one of the lesser commonly used ones, and you'll see why in a second. I'm going to walk you through the whole cycle so that you can understand kind of all the different points that are involved in it, and then we'll get to some of the more commonly used methods. So the first method I'm going to show you is what I like to refer to as more the manual method. And that's a situation where, let's say we don't have a sync with our bank, so we don't have any automatic information coming in. We don't really have any information here at all from the bank side. All we have is the transactions that exist in our NetSuite instance, and then maybe we have a paper printout of our bank records, or maybe we have another screen that has a login to our bank so we can see the lines that are in our bank and we can see the lines that are here in our NetSuite instance. And we're going to do a reconciliation line to line in that way. So what we would do in that particular instance is we can go through these lines. So again, let's say I have a paper from my bank in front of me and I'm comparing line by line. I can select these things. Right, I have all these check boxes. You can see what type of payment, the date. You can see what's the either customer or the vendor, also the amount. So you've got all these different things here and I can select them. And if I come to the bottom here, at the bottom, as I select things, you know, notice these three that I've selected so far populate down here. So as things are matched on the top, both on the NetSuite side as well as the bank side, it's going to copy these things down to the bottom. So you'll see kind of like what's already been matched up at this point. And you can also notice there's kind of a running difference here. So ideally you get to a point where there is no difference and everything is fully reconciled between the two. So in this case, let's say I've gone through, I've compared my little paper document to this bank reconciliation list, and I'm gonna select, let's say everything matched up perfectly. So I have everything selected and I can come to the bottom here. And what I can do is, it's a little hard to see here, but this is a button that says clear. And basically what that's doing is it's saying, you'll see as we go through this, there's a few different steps that it puts you through. You don't just reconcile everything. It's gonna put you through a few phases to make sure that everything is matching up appropriately and that you're fine with that. So the first thing you do, once you've selected everything and said, yes, this is all matching, we're gonna hit this clear button. And what that does is it takes all that information that we've just verified and it puts it up in this tab up here, this review tab. So all of these bills and payments that we just cleared, so we've said that it verified and it matched up with our bank record, is now all here and we can review them and make sure, yes, these are all the correct payments, the bills, the amounts are correct, so everything here is totally fine. Once that's done, we're gonna come up here to submit. So if we click submit, we've now taken all of those records and we've put them basically available to have the reconciliation process occur. And the way we get to that is we come up over here to the right, this reconcile account statement. So we're gonna click on that. And you can see We have this one account selected. Obviously, if you have different accounts, you'd want to make sure you have the correct one selected. We also have the statement end date. That might be the end of the month, and it might be some random date for this particular account where the statement technically ends. And then I'm going to jump past this for a second, and you can see all of these bills and payments that we just submitted, right, from that match bank data that we had. We submitted them all, and now they're here. Up until that moment, this was an empty list, but now that I've submitted it, it populates them all here, so we can see them. We can also see a total. And in this case, again, there was no bank information to match up to, so the difference looks pretty astronomical with minus 790,000. And we also have the ability right here to put in an ending statement balance. So notice if I try to click this reconcile button, I can't do it yet because I have to have these three fields correctly filled in before I can technically reconcile. So let's say, again, this is not, I don't have a real bank to compare to. So I'm just gonna put in a figure, let's say $5. You're gonna wanna make sure you put in the correct ending statement balance there. But let's say we put in $5. So we now have the ability to hit reconcile, which would complete the cycle, and we would be done again for that account. We'd be done with the bank reconciliation, and we'd then be able to move on to other month-end closing activities. So that's how that works, and that's the first method, keep in mind. So let's go back to our match bank data. We're gonna come back here, and so we're back on this page, left side bank info, right side NetSuite, and we have the account selected here. So let's now take a look. Everything I just showed you for that first method, which is the manual method, was assuming that everything matched up perfectly. There was no problems, but that's rarely the case, right? There's a lot of instances where there's gonna be something, some sort of a discrepancy. So what do you do to handle that? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna scroll to the bottom here, and you can see we have these little buttons here. We have add journal entry, add charge, and add deposit. So let's say the bank shows having less money than our NetSuite instance. So maybe there was a vendor bill or something that got missed. It charged to our account, but it was not recorded in NetSuite. So how might we go about solving that? You can come here and you could simply add a journal entry or charge to bring down the NetSuite instance amount so that it matches up with the bank. Or you might have an instance where the bank is saying it has more money than our NetSuite instance. So somehow more money was put in the bank than we recorded in NetSuite. You could add a deposit to, again, reconcile the two amounts. However, while those three options are available to you, that's not the recommended method. The recommended method, to take the example I just used, where let's say a vendor bill was charged but then fell through the cracks and wasn't recorded in NetSuite, the proper method to handle that would be simply generate the necessary vendor bill, make sure that it's recorded. Obviously, don't do anything that's gonna make a double charge, but you do wanna make sure that those records are properly saved in NetSuite. So that is the recommended method to go about doing any kind of reconciliation. So now that we've looked at the manual method and really gone through the entire process, now let's take a look at the second method, which is by far the most common method and really the recommended way to go about this, which is using a bank feed. And really how that works is you're going to set up between your NetSuite instance and your actual bank account, let's say it's Bank of America, there's a process where you go in and you actually sync up to that bank. You have to make sure you put in the correct information, the passwords, et cetera. Once you have that bank feed set up, then what happens is you can come in here, as soon as you put in the correct account, it links up to that bank feed and it would populate automatically, not just the NetSuite info, but also the bank info. Once you have those two lined up, then you can use a feature down here. You see this match button, you click match, and what it will do is it's going to suddenly sync these things up and it's gonna go, oh, this bill payment for Davidson Leasing, that I can see that here. I can see the date matches, I can see the vendor matches, also the amount. It's actually relatively intuitive. It gets a lot of it correct. So it'll match up these two things, and anything that doesn't match up, you can then go through manually and say, oh, I can tell, I can see why it got confused, but this should link up to that, and you can match them manually. And you eventually get to a point, ideally, where you have everything is correctly matching, or you solve whatever the discrepancy is. So that's using a bank feed. Now, like I mentioned earlier, this is a demo account. There is no real bank attached to this, so I can't show you a bank feed for this particular instance. And I'd like to point out, generally bank feeds would be set up more by whoever, let's say a consultant, is doing your NetSuite implementation, usually that person would go about setting up those bank feeds and making sure that all works, or potentially even your administrator who's more advanced with NetSuite and knows how to do that. That type of person would set this up more likely than, let's say, an accountant. Now, if you are in the administrator role and you do want to do something with bank feed, the way you would access that is by going up to setup, and then you would come down to accounting. And within the accounting window, there's a financial institutions tab, and you would select that. And again, you'd have to go through, it's a bit of an extensive process, so I'm not going to get into that here. But one point I do want to make is that that bank feed, as I commented, you do need to sync it up in the beginning. And keep in mind, let's say if there's a situation where you change the passwords to your banks, let's say every month or every year, as soon as a password changes, it's gonna break that bank feed. So whether it's you or the administrator, whoever's organizing these things, would, anytime a password changes, would need to go back to that bank feed by going through the setup, accounting, financial institutions, and resync that bank feed to make sure that it is still populating information in here. So once you have the bank feed set up, you have the information here, you do that match, you make sure everything's synced up, you would then go through the whole process I showed you in the first method. You would clear it, you would review it, you'd submit it, and then you would do the final reconciliation. All the same steps from that point on. So that's the second method. And again, I'd say that's definitely the most common and the most recommended method to use. However, the bank feed doesn't always work. It's good a lot of the times, but there can be quirks, or you might break the sync and you still need to do your bank reconciliation regardless. So one additional way you can actually go about doing that is by importing the bank statement into NetSuite and populating it here using the import. So the way you would go about doing that is we're gonna come up to financial, we're gonna go back down to banking, we're gonna go down to banking import history, and you can click on upload file. So you come to this window, and it's very similar like doing a CSV import. You basically drop the file in here, and you need to make sure that you have the right file type. That's pretty important. So you can see the different file types that are available here. Now CSV, when you're doing a normal import, let's say for transactions, you generally want to stick with a CSV import. However, when doing a bank reconciliation, I do not recommend using a CSV file. For whatever reason, it tends to create problems and have just little quirks and idiosyncrasies. So CSV is definitely not the recommended file choice. Best to go with something like an OFX or a QFX. Both of those are Quicken type files. Even if you don't use Quicken, don't worry, you can still import that file type into this system. Now, if for whatever reason the Quicken files aren't working or not able to get it in that file format, you can rely on one of these other file formats. For example, BAI2 is a format that you can use. If the others aren't working appropriately, you can try that one out and see if you can avoid some of the problems you're running into. Regardless, you're gonna wanna import that file. Once that's done, you can, again, come back up here. You would put in the account info. Now that you've imported that bank record for, and it would be attached to that account, it again, it should populate all that information. Steps are exactly the same after that. You do a match, you handle any discrepancies, you then clear that information, you review it here, you submit it, you go over to reconcile account statement, and you finish the reconciliations. All the same steps from that point out. The fourth method is, let's say this match bank data tool is simply not working. There's just running into errors, it's not working as it should, and you wanna have a backup that you can rely on. There actually is another method to go about doing a bank reconciliation, and you would approach that by going to financial, down to banking, and then you're gonna come down here to reconcile bank statement. So if we click on that, now, the first thing you'll notice here is this big yellow banner that says deprecated. And what that means is that this is a tool that NetSuite is trying to phase out. It's an old tool. The new one is the match bank data. So this is something that at some point won't exist at all. At this moment in time, though, it is still available and you can use it if all else fails with the match bank data tool. Now, the way this works is, instead of having all these different steps, they kind of just say, listen, click the buttons, make sure they reconcile, and hit submit, and you're done. We can simply add the correct account. Now, here's an important thing to notice. This is one caveat to using this method of reconciliation. To be able to reconcile a particular account, you actually have to change the settings on that account first. So we're gonna come up to financial, we're gonna go down to lists and we're gonna come up to accounts. So I'm gonna click on that. This brings up our chart of accounts. And if we come down here to the type, if I sort it by type, if I click on that button, you'll see I have all my banks lined up here. So I can scroll down and right here, see this checking US West? That was the one that we were using for the match bank data tool. So this is the one we wanna edit to make, change the feature so we can use this deprecated old tool to be able to do the bank reconciliation. So I'm gonna come over here and I'm gonna hit edit on this checking US West. So it brings me to this page and the only thing we need to influence is this checkbox right here, use match bank data. So it's basically saying this one is gonna be only for match bank data and what we need to do is unselect that and hit save. Great, so we've now changed that account. If we come back to this tool, this Reconcile Bank Statement tool, and we're going to refresh, now notice the account here suddenly fills in with that account that wasn't available before. Now we can utilize that US West checking account. So we've got that account locked in. We've got the statement date, start date, the ending statement balance. So a lot of the same information we were looking at in the other tool is here. We've got all of these different charges and payments here. Again, we can select them as needed. We can mark all if we want. But as I mentioned before, instead of going through many steps to do this, they really cut it down to simply you select what you want, you hit save, and that's it. It's gonna reconcile it right then and there. And that's it for bank reconciliations in NetSuite. I'll see you in the next video.